I think it was supposed to be written for a ballet, and it was definitely Brown's influenced by Bartok and Stravinsky. It was very rhythmic music and spontaneous too, and that mixed with the Afro-Cuban music. It was quite I think the music is very. Very strong rhythm for this big part of the music. So this, I mean, you have the rhythmic, lots of rhythmic episodes, and then you have lots of, I think I described that atmospheric flourishes, and lots of the colour that you're doing is super. I think all that I'm going to do is just maybe again exaggerate some things, and maybe what we can do with some of the rooms is keep it a little bit tighter. This is fantastic, but and you have very quick left hand. But you probably don't need. Have you played this with a metronome? Yeah. Well, I think what happens is that probably again we all race a little bit when we see these semi-quavers. And I know this. I do it, and I often don't realize sometimes. And but you can really hear it when I hear students play. Why is that rushing? And I realize it's just what we do. But if we can have a great control, then some of these things I think can sound a little bit more rhythmic because you have a tighter, you've got a stronger sense of pulse through. These quicker, more difficult passages. And it can also be a little easier because we're not racing off into the distance. Now, you were playing those with great ease. Fantastic. But I think if we just try and stick to this steady pulse there, when we get to there, hopefully it can be even better. So, from the beginning, nice colours. Real big contrast of that dynamic, which I think is fantastic. Just be careful that you don't go too far, because I think it's actually at the beginning, you don't really hit a forte until a little bit later on. So it's still mezzo forte, mezzo piano, although I really like the range. But maybe you can save that range for a tiny bit further on into the piece. So let's go again from the beginning. And here you're setting up a pulse too, you know, you get this very nice and steady. So same thing, but just not as strong at the end. Very good. Yeah, very good. With these things here, remember, what is the right hand fingering you're doing? So P-I-A, and then thumb and what, M or A. I don't think it matters as long as, again, you're ready. And also, I think if you could just let this hang about a little bit longer with a bit of vibrato again, especially the end of it. The markings is left by grade sustained. Yeah. So sorry, that was my comeback. Sorry about that. Very good. Really good. Here's something. That actual intensity of vibrato probably does suit the intensity of the music there. But I would maybe again relax the vibrato a tiny bit, save something for later if you need it. So that vibrato was certainly vibrato, but it was very intense. Can you relax it?
I'm thinking of that passage. I mean, ideally, the sound I'd want to hear is the sound of the fun, but I find it really difficult to execute. So I've come up with a fingering where, and I find if I do use the fun, it kind of slows down a bit.
Yeah.
And I haven't hit on. I noticed you were using your thumb there, Roland, and you were making it.
Yeah, it's fit. Strong. I mean, this fingering here is fine. Yeah, the fingering that is written above, is that yours or is yeah, I think that works, really works. The only thing is that I would then, if you're coming down here, as I say, just take care of so you put the thumb back on the opening, yeah? Because otherwise you have it's a little muddy sounding. Or you play it go from the rosette maybe back to pasta. So from here, but less. Good. only your fingers are really flying and you're getting all the notes, but this is where the metronome can help you again. Just try and play a few times, more times with the metronome right here, because it's going so quick and you're nailing it. But I think, again, I would just want to hear this stay this time. Actually, the rhythm here is the triplet is this. It's really tricky. Not straight away, but. It's really difficult to separate. I mean, I think if you go with the arpeggio, it would be okay. But if you can make maybe that adjustment, I think the fingering might help you with a bit more clarity with the arpeggio, so you're falling through with it. Yeah, right. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, good. And the trick is to push through with the thumb, not to pluck each one, because then I think you get a greater regard for fluency with the arpeggio. Yeah? Good. Great, let's move on. This Take my fingers, you try and keep in time with this. Okay. Yeah, good, I'm trying to catch up. But again, the metronome won't be able to do what I'm doing, trying to catch up or waving around with the pulse. But can you see that this actually is not that fast? Yeah, you were playing it. It was incredibly impressive, but actually, you don't need to sweat that much. Don't worry so much. I mean, you probably weren't worrying if you were flying through it, but it was just, again, a slightly different tempo from what you need there. Okay? So, then, give it a go from... So just a tiny bit of work with keeping those triplets under, really rhythmically strong, and I think you'll be playing fantastically well. And the thing for this would be maybe PPI. We do experiment, but it's